one of our teachers and also technical director, Gaston Dering. You're calling his attention to some of the things that you guys are doing. Henceforth, he won't be able to do that for you guys. We're going to assign someone that will be helping you guys on the Telegram platform, because there are every responsibility that he has to tidy up on his own end. So please, we would adequately introduce one of our support analysts on Telegram to you guys. So you guys should be calling forth. Look forward to that. And you guys should be calling his name, as it were. And I'm sure he's going to help you accordingly. So I think there are quite a number of things for us to do as a company and as a school. Very important. So before we start, I want us to, whether you are online, whether you are in the hall, can you go to YouTube, please? I think it's time for us not to be selfish. Can we go to YouTube? And when you get to YouTube, if you're unable to do it now, when you get to YouTube, but ensure you do that, because we're going to monitor it strictly. When you go to YouTube, just click TC Resource Technology. I'm sure you can see my screen now, and that's going to bring that up for you. So what you are supposed to do is to ensure that you subscribe to our channel, which is very important. Can I confirm that you can see my screen, please? No. Can you see my screen? Hello, can I get a response from those who are online? Okay, thank you. So ensure that you get online and thank you very much. So you need to subscribe. Every video that you would need is on there. And I'm wondering, would you watch the, there are a couple of videos that you have there, so you can download and watch offline later, which is critically important. So guys, we need you guys to do that. Like I said, we're going to monitor that. And some of you are sharing your LinkedIn profile on our Telegram. Don't do that for now. Don't do that for now. Every pictures, everything you want to do, go on LinkedIn, send it directly there, which is quite important. Send it directly there, and we should be able to move forward. Now, moving ahead today, I'm sure you guys can see my screen. We're going to be looking at our general data protection and regulation today, which is one of the important topics. Now, whether you are an engineer, a lawyer, a medical doctor, a data analyst, a project manager, the governor of the state, the president of the country, it does not matter who you are, really. You have got to comply with the order of the day. With the order of the day. And I have critically looked at the data protection and regulation in United Kingdom and Nigeria. They are all the same. The only difference is the regulatory body that regulates Nigeria is called NIIT, which you guys are aware. So that is the body in Nigeria that regulates the use of data in Nigeria. Now, the use of data in Europe is regulated by EU GDPR, is regulated by that particular body. Now, regulated by ICO rather. Now, the thing is called EU GDPR. Why are we teaching EU GDPR? Why are we not teaching data protection in line with what is applicable in Nigeria? Like I said to you, it's pretty much the same thing. If the only thing is the agency, the government agency that regulates the two. Now, the fact that you are on our platform and the company is in Euro, now we needed to teach EU GDPR, because you're going to have access to quite a number of our materials, like our slide, like our student data. You're going to pretty much have access to that. And for those who are friends and families working, when you are given an appointment, there are forms that you have got to sign. There are forms that your lecturers, your teachers in your school signed when they pick up an appointment with LASSO. That means that in the course of discharging their duty, they will come across confidential data, confidential information. And as such, they have to protect the integrity of that data that they have seen or whatever they have come across. The same way, in the course of discharge, in the course of being, thank you. I can see quite a number of you already subscribing, which is beautiful. Now, for quite a number of you, you're going to come across quite a number of our materials, and it's important to let you know. If you look at the link that we sent to you, the Google link, I'm not talking about the one you filled in last week, the one we sent, not Google link, the main champion that we sent to you on the Telegram, you will see at the bottom of that link, we clearly show to you what your data to do. It's important for you what we are going to use your data to do. Very important. It's critically important for us to tell you what we are going to use your data to do. It's only going to be for your learning, nothing more. Beyond that, we will be held culpable. So we won't be able to do that. So that's why, instead of concentrating on NIIT, we rather concentrate on this part. Like I said, everything is pretty much the same thing. The only thing there is the regulatory body that's just the only difference. Now, moving ahead, what is GDPR? I've named GDPR, General Data Protection and Regulation. And whether you are in Congo, whether you are in Nigeria, whether you are in Canada, if you go on our LinkedIn, you will see some of the pictures of our current cut across the globe. You will see pictures of students who currently work for Edo State government, particularly the Ministry of Budget and Economic Planning. That is a very important department in the economics of the state, as you can imagine. Now, you also see quite a number of people who are currently working for Dangote. You will also see, oh, that's on our LinkedIn profile. Then you also see quite a number of students talking to you from Netherlands. The one from United Arab Emirates is going to see those videos in the course of the week. Now, it's important to protect your data. Now, we on the platform now, I have Amos Alagbe, I have Friday Senapon, I have Idara, I have even the Adi for last week. Now, it is critically important that we protect your data. I remember this year, April, actually, no, I think it was last year, November, when I was coming to Nigeria. The British Airways plane. I had my name, my last name, my date of birth, what I do, where I'm going to. And at the bottom, there was nothing that showed to me that my data would be protected, because they are supposed to put something, whether it's a paper form, whether it's a digital form, whichever form you are giving, they are supposed to tell you that your data is protected. Imagine if I fill that form, put on my data, details there, and I gave it to one of the cabin crew, and she took it from me. And while she was taking everybody, so you can imagine how many papers they're going to collate, how many hard copy papers they are going to pick up, even if they are about 16 cabin crew. So you can imagine that there's a likelihood that one person might be having as much as 20 papers in his or her hand. Now, what if one of the papers dropped from her hand and someone else in the plane picks up that information? After picking up that information, committed the fraud in my name, what then happens? What then happens? That means I'm not able to sue British Airways. I'm not able to hold them culpable or responsible for losing my data. I'm sure some of you saw an incident that happened on the TV about a Nigerian who went to Nigerian House in London to get his passport. This guy has applied for his passport, and the normal trend is you have to come back again to come and collect your passport, and whether you are renewing or you are getting a visa or whatever it is. Now, I have done it before. If you are unable to get there by 1 p.m., the door will be shut against you, and it is ridiculous. In this day and age, technology should have been properly addressed that particular issue. You shouldn't go back again. And imagine, you have Cardiff, Wales rather, and then you have England, as it were, in all the United Kingdom. You even have Ireland, all the United Kingdom. So if you are traveling from Scotland, which is about 6 hours, so you can imagine you travel 6 hours and you are unable to meet that 1 p.m. slot, and then they lock you outside. That is ridiculous. Can you imagine? So irrespective of how much you used to fly to London, or you take train, or you even drive, and driving and parking in the heart of London is ridiculous. You can be paying as much as £25 a day. So you can imagine. So I've experienced it. If you do not make it by 1 p.m., it's trouble. So this guy decided, when they stopped him from entering, I don't know where the guy was coming from. I don't know the issue really, but the guy was pissed off and he broke a couple of Benz that was parked just in front of the Nigerian House. And I believe those Benz belongs to the Nigerian House. So the guy broke it, broke the windscreen, you know, caused a public disorder, let's put it that way. And because of that, police were called in. Of course, there are two different things. Police have to arrest him because of public order. And meanwhile, people pick up this guy's data page where it has his name, his date of birth, the date it was issued, that particular maybe expired passport or new passport, and send it on social media. That is against data protection, whether Nigeria, whether Congo, whether Yugoslavia, any country. That's against. That means Nigerian House is in trouble. That means Nigeria is in trouble. Because in the first place, who would have posted that bio data of that guy's passport on a social media? Of course, it wouldn't be that guy. The guy has overreacted, no doubt. That caused public disorder. People walking about without panic attacks because of that disorder. Yes, we agree. But then, you caused trouble. You rioted in your school. And the next day, your data was being posted. That is wrong. It shouldn't. So that was a big deal. And most of the lawyers who are practicing, who are data protection lawyers, they had to come to that guy's aid. And I'm sure they said to it at the end. But of course, no doubt Nigeria will have to pay. So when you go against non-compliance, against data usage, data sharing, data collection in Europe, in Europe, in England, it is 20 million euro. That's what you're going to pay. Now, if a company and your asset, your liability, your profit, whatever is not up to that amount, whatever you are worth, it is 4% of that annual global turnover. 4% of whatever you are, including your fixed asset, including your everything. Your current asset and your fixed asset, 4% of it. So if a new company who is just starting up mess about, so you can imagine that they could close that particular company. Now, according to data protection, whether in Nigeria, whether Europe, when a company breach against the law, they have to report themselves. They don't have to wait for you to report them. They have to report themselves within 72 hours. That's what the law states. Now, let's come back a little bit. Let's start picking it one by one. Can somebody help me deal with a couple of people who are online and their mic is not initiated, for them to initiate their mic so that they can hear what is being taught? Now, let's start picking it from the very beginning. What is data? Data has to do with your personal information. And what are these personal information? We are talking about your name, whether your middle name, your first name, your last name, your name. Anything that has to do with your name is your data. It belongs to you. Your date of birth, your email, your house address, your blood genotype. Your medical report, anything that has to do with you, your IP address, that's your personal data, your sex, I mean your gender rather, in different countries they refer it to be something else, your religion, that's your personal data, and you are entitled to keep your personal data. You are clearly entitled to keep your personal data. Now, your political opinion. These are your personal data. Your race, your health data, your biometrics, your genetic data, everything, your sexual orientation, whether you are this or you are that, your trade union membership, it's your all personal data. That's all. That's you. And what are you? You are a data subject. The person that owns that data is called data subject. That is you as a person. That's your data. It's called data subject. You are the data subject. Now, those that can use they are called processor. Now, who has the authority to be collecting data? That is called a controller, data controller. That's called data controller. That's the person. Now you can see the individual is called data subject. The data controller is an entity. Now, a data subject has to be a natural person and a living being, not a dead being, a living being, a natural living being. That is you. You are the data subject. You are the individual that owns the data. Now, the data controller is either the CEO of an organization or the organization itself. And of course, there will always be somebody in the ends of affair who has the authority, who the organization gave the authority to. So whether it is the general manager, whether it is the president, whether it's the chairman, it determines, number one, listen to me critically. It determines where the data should be stored. It determines what kind of data should be collected. It determines who should collect that data, who should have access to that data, what the data should be used for. For example, in last month, can somebody tell me who the data controller is going to be with this video? Can somebody tell me, please? Come on, guys. Let's make it interactive. Ebuka, Amos, Adeyeye. Send a text message. Send a chat on the platform. Who do you think is going to be the data controller in last week? Come on, guys. It doesn't take long to type this thing now. We don't have time. The data controller, if you're not going to tell me, I'm going to tell you. Somebody has told me. What do you mean, IT specialist? Have you been listening to me, Amos? Have you been listening to me? Or what have you been listening to? What do you mean, data specialist? IT specialist. The Vice Chancellor, Abel, thank you. Thank you very much. The Vice Chancellor, thank you very much. I love the way you put it, the Vice Chancellor. Yeah, I like the way you put it. Thank you. So, what do you mean set up the system? What system are you talking about? The Vice Chancellor is a data controller. Now, every other person, whether IT specialist like Amos said, or dean of faculty, or vice chancellor admin, or whatever it is called, all of them put together, they are processor. They were given authority by the vice chancellor to have access to that data. So the organ of the school, I mean the boss in the school, is the data controller. Like I said, in any of the CEO or the general manager, whoever is in the aims of affair is the data controller. That's the data controller. And there must be an agreement between the person who happens to be the data controller and every other staff to clearly show that you must comply with the data usage in this school. You cannot use the data for your own personal sentiment or for your own personal correspondence. You cannot do that. There must be a very clear agreement. So now it's important to come back a little bit. The regulatory body, can somebody help me to talk to people who are just logging in and ask no audio? Can you guys talk to them, please? I have a Charity Online. Yes, can you help me talk to these guys, please? And I have Musa Online. So please, can you guys talk to these guys? So very, very importantly, there must be an agreement. Now, the regulatory body in all this country, like I said, what we have in Nigeria is NIIT. Their effectiveness, their performance differs. Some regulatory body, they perform to the task. They protect. No, before now, the country tends to favor the big guys. That was why you see Facebook fall into trouble. Facebook was in trouble. The law favors these big guys. They can collect data anyhow without getting your consent. They can take your data, sell your data, make money over your data, and you cannot do anything because you won't even know. But with the advent of the new data law across board, across the country, then now the regulatory body, the law now favors the data subject. That is the individual who owns data. The company, nobody is allowed to collect your data without getting your consent. If you notice, when Facebook started, they don't seek for your own opinion. But towards last year, if you notice, quite a number of privacy policies popping up on your different right. Please, need response. I've muted everybody. You can unmute yourself. But so if you notice, so I need response on the chat line. So if you notice, towards the middle of last year, quite a number of pop-up were coming up on Facebook to request for your consent to use your data. Noticed. Yes, that's true. But prior to this time, the law tends to favor the big guys, the companies. They can collect data anyhow, take the data, store it any which way, sell the data, you won't even know, like I said. And you will just, they carry on to do that. But with the advent of the new laws as regards data usage, data storage, data process across the country, across every country, So the law now favors the data subject who happens to be the owner of the data that is being used. And that's why when you go to Punch newspaper, I listen to Nigerian news every day. There's no day that goes by that I don't listen to Nigerian news. No day. There's no day that goes by that I don't read Punch newspaper. There's no day. So if you know reading Punch newspaper online, I'm not talking about paper one. Online, when you go to read it, there are pop-up that tells you, okay, what they will use your data. In fact, to be honest with you, some of them are not even doing it very well. And that is wrong. And that's why I said that the regulatory body that regulates the use of data in different countries, their effectiveness, their performance differs. Their performance, how they function differs. Some are just sleeping, while some are actually involved. That's why I said that when there's a breach, when a company collects your data without your consent, that's a big breach. Or if they get your consent, they said, okay, Amos Alagbe, if I pronounce your name wrongly, apologies. If they collect your data to say, okay, Ebuka, we are going to use your data for learning process, and you find out that they are using your data wrongly, you are not even supposed to report them. They are supposed to report themselves to the regulatory body to say, I have wrongly, or one of their staff have wrongly done this and that. And that's why I said that there must always be an agreement between the organization and its workforce, that is its staff. There must be an agreement to say, okay, you have been employed by Lasso, you will not use this the data that you in the course of your discharge, you for your own personal sentiment. That should be clearly addressed. The dog is the owner of the data. The data processor is the person that is given authority to use the data. The data controller is all these people are, they are all living persons. Now, the data controller is an entity. Why do we call him an entity? He has authority to determine what kind of data they should collect. Just like your vice chancellor, he tells the IT specialist, like Amos said, he tells them, I need you to design a form for application, for maybe educational application into Lasso. It has to capture first name, last name, middle name, email address, the state you are from, whether you are indigenous or you are not indigenous, your gender, and what have you. So there was somebody that gave them the authority to do that. Otherwise, they shouldn't go ahead to do that. So that means there's an agreement that is protecting these people. Please, can I get some responses? So there are some responses. I need some responses, please. Thank you. I didn't say you should tell me you are okay. Okay. That means that you guys are following. Awesome, beautiful. So with where we are now, you can imagine. So now, why are we teaching GDPR? So imagine now. That's why on this particular chart, you can see third country, third parties. We are using Zoom platform to teach. Now, before, we are not the owner of Zoom. We have to pay for it. TC Resource Technology has to pay for Zoom on a monthly basis to use Zoom. So it's not ours. So when we wanted to start, we had to get a consent from Zoom to say, guys, this is what we do. We need your platform to be able to reach the whole world. Now, let's assume you now become our full student. Let's say you become our full student, as it were. We will have your data. And as you have logged in now, I produce Rashid Rafiu, Ola Leri Bolaji, Lasu Admin, Lasu CBC has logged in. Your details had already been captured by the system. The system had already captured your name. It had already captured everything. Now, I needed to establish an agreement with Zoom to say, guys, what if now that you have access to my people's data, what if at the end of this course, I want to request for all the data that they have captured, that they need to delete it from their system. I should be able to do that. So before acquiring Zoom, there is an agreement between Zoom and myself, or whatever material we are going to use, that we did not produce or create our own. So we have to tell them that, guys, see, whenever we request to recall back all the data that you have, you must be able to give us. That was what Facebook could not do. That was why Facebook was in trouble. So every platform, every organization that come to Facebook and they have access to your detail, at the time, Facebook could not control that traffic. There was no agreement between Facebook and this company to say they can recall back, because as a data subject, now that we have made Amos Alagbe to come on our platform, he has the right to write to TC Resource Technology to say, please, all the data that you have on me, can you delete it? That means that you have the right to request for deletion of all your data. To erase all your data, you have the right as a data subject. One, it's your data. So you have the right to give it, and you have the right to withdraw the consent that you gave. So what is consent? Consent is giving approval of your data. Consent is called giving approval. So you can withdraw the approval. If you finish from Lasso, for example, now, you can recall back all your data and say, Lasso, I don't want you to have access to, I don't want to store my data anymore. Please send, recall back all my data. So whatever files you have filled 10 years ago, they should be able to lay hands on it. All those things are all in Nigeria data protection and regulation. Is there? Let's do something quickly. We started quite late, so we're not going to do more than 1 hour for this. Let's data protection in Nigeria. Let's look at something. Let's look at it. Is here? NITDA rather, not NIT. NITDA. Let's look at it. You see everything that I've been talking about. Everything that I've been talking about. Whether data subject, whether data controller, what have you. You will see everything. Can you see? Nigeria Data Protection Regulation. Can you see? Let's look at it. Let's look at it together. Okay, it's talking about the Regulatory Body Act 2007. So there are articles guiding all those laws. So you see a lawyer in the law court say article this, article that, blah 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 blah. Now, what is data? Let's see. I deliberately don't want to open. It means character, symbols, binary on which operate are performed by a computer. blah, 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 blah. Database means collection of data. Data administration means a person or an organization that processes data. Okay, they call it data administrator. Data controller means a person who either alone, jointly with other persons, or in common with other persons, or as a statutory body, as an entity, determine the purpose for data and the manner in which the personal data is processed or to be processed. Did you see? Did you see? Yes, that's why I'm not teaching from Nigerian perspective. Thank you, Constance. Thank you for sending it to everybody, actually. Yes, that's the trouble. And that's why I said, that the regulatory bodies, their performance and their effectiveness differs across the country. NITDA is not doing, there was a time I wanted to teach them. There was a time I sent them a proposal. We wanted to do it. It's still open anyway. It's still open because they don't know what they are doing. Imagine some of them are political appointees who do not know what their left and their right. So so they won't know what to do, actually. They won't know what to do. So you can see data portability. They just bring you some funny definition. And so data subject access request means mechanism for individual to request a copy of data under a formal process, payment of a fee, what have you. So that's why I'm not teaching from Nigerian perspective, even though the only difference is just personal data breach, a breach of the security, incidental or unlawful disclosure of or access to personal data transmitted, stored or otherwise processed. So a breach is simply you didn't give your data, you didn't give your consent yet. They were able to have access to that data, or you gave your consent, and yet, when you try to withdraw, they didn't comply. Have you noticed terms and conditions of products being sold in Nigeria? They are written in tiny print. I need responses. Have you noticed? That shouldn't be. It shouldn't be. According to the data law, it should be written in a format that is clear, concise, readable to whoever. It should be clear and concise and precise, very clear, not too bogus or I'm bringing some ambiguity to it. No, it shouldn't. It shouldn't. You buy a product, they will write it in a piece of paper, very long, very tiny print that it is tiring to even read. No. According to the law, it should be in big letters. That's the way it should. So a lot of things are quite wrong. And that's why about them, when they are, you can see those are examples of personal data. You see your name, your address, your photo, your picture, your email address, your bank details, your social media network website, your media medical information. Your IP address, your MAC address, your IME, these are numbers that they don't even get your call, they just take it. Your SIM, whatever. When I told you when I flew British Airways and I came to Nigeria via British Airways, I already filled that form. I declined, I said, until you can tell me that my data is protected, I'm not filling this. Call it whoever you want to call. Of course, they can't argue because that's my profession. That's what I do. And when I got to Nigeria, the same thing, they gave me a form to fill. I didn't fill it. I said, I need you to tell me that whoever you are representing, I don't need to see your guy. There's no need. But whoever you are representing, I need it clearly stated that my data is. What if at the end of the day, the immigration officer went drunk and did not submit the file? He left it at the beer parlor where he has had a drink and somebody does yahoo. That's why there are so many troubles in Nigeria. Yeah, you wish you were a lawyer. And that's true. In fact, some of my staff, I wish they were a lawyer. Some of them talk like they were a lawyer. One of them is here. They behave like they were lawyers. So those are critical things. In United Kingdom, in Europe, whether they employ you as a data scientist, a project manager, a medical doctor, the first thing you will deal with in that company the very first week or 2 weeks is information of data usage and protection. That's what you will deal with, irrespective of whatever position you occupy. So when you feel, that's why we have to make you to feel another form. When you feel Lasso Potter form, that's how I have to make you feel another form. Yeah, being the senior director for TC Resource Technology at the same time, the CEO of TC Resource Technology, I have to make sure things are right. I have to make sure things are right. Because you don't want to suddenly fall victim of these things. I told you, as big as Facebook is, he had trouble. I'm sure some of you saw on YouTube how it was caught to panic in America and they had to pay a huge amount of money. Quite a lot of things are going on. So those things that you are sending, that's why I said, do not send your LinkedIn profile on our Telegram platform. Don't. Go to LinkedIn. I'm not sure whether you sign data protection or whatever, but go there. Now, when you send your LinkedIn, whether you have 50 connections, it does not matter. I have told you before, I told you last year, it does not matter. What matters is what you do with that connection that you have. You want to get employed fast. Let me tell you one secret today. You want to get employment fast, right? Let me tell you one simple thing that you need to do. Go on LinkedIn. Go and write an article on problem in your sector, the sector that you want to work in. Whether you're an accountant, go and write on LinkedIn. LinkedIn is owned by Microsoft, so it's owned by big top guys. It's owned by Microsoft. So every professional across the whole world is there. So this GM of a particular company in India, in Nigeria, they're all there. And the trouble, you might not know, but you might be talking in your article. You might be talking about the trouble that company is going through. And because you are providing solution, they will reach out to you. Whether you are in Niger State or Kano State or whatever, wherever you are, or one kubiku in Agegule, it does not matter where you are. They will reach out to you. Because you have just spoken, you have just declared what they want, the solution that they want, not having connection, thousands of connections every day. That does not bring anything to you. Did LinkedIn say, when you have 1 billion connections, they will give you money? Please, I need answer. Did they tell you that? Thank you. Did they tell you that? No. So why are you crazy about connections? I just told you one secret to get employed. You are thinking about anti-punctionism, but advertise one major role. I told you last week, major role in Nigeria, big boys role, big jobs in Nigeria, they are not advertised. And it's not because they want to give it to one political appointees. Don't deceive yourself. I know you have to know. I'm still in Nigeria, even though I'm in the UK. It's my field. I'm by the grace of God, I am the CEO, so I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about clearly. So go there, write an article in the area where you want to work. Profile solution. So that means take time to research. You want to get into First Bank. Go and research the trouble First Bank is going through and send an article. Tag the people. Just don't send, tag the people. There are people who are working in First Bank that you can see. So tag them, the big boys, tag them there. So those big jobs, they don't deceive yourself. It will never be advertised because there's no point advertising them because the skill set to feed them, they are not rampant. They are very few. They are not there. All these things that we are teaching you, are they the job specific? Are they in Nigeria? Yes. To become a project manager, they are there. PMO analyst, they are there. They are all there. But there is no skill set to occupy them. And those courses are not adequately being taught at the schools. Adequately. Yeah. They always sell your data. And they are supposed not to. They sell your data. Mind you, not only giving your data, they sell your data to third-party companies. They can make huge amount of money over your data. That's why you are receiving some silly advert, whether on Facebook or everywhere. It's even silly in UK here, in Europe, where you start receiving some unnecessary calls. But it has reduced now because they know when they receive call, just tell them, send me an email instead, because you need evidence to prosecute them. You need evidence.
That's why they cannot do it to those big lawyers, big personality in Nigeria, because they know the law. They know the law. So it would take them to get somebody that they will pay $2 million to, and they would now sue that company or sue that agency or sue whoever that sought for their consent or use their data, and they will get times 10 of that $2 million that they pay to the lawyer. That's why they can't try to Femi Falana or this big boy or this banker. They can't try it with them because they understood the law. So I think I'm going to wrap up from here. I know it's quite interesting. A lot of things. So there's a way to deal with this. That's why we have to send you another form. Somebody might say, oh, why are you sending us another one? No. I'm not sure. I'm not part of the portal that you feel. So I'm not sure what was written there. I have to protect my company. I have to protect myself. I have to send you another form to say, and in the form, if you remember clearly, it stated that your data would only be used for your learning process only. That's all. And you have the right to tell us, TC Resource Technology, I don't want you to have my name again. Please delete my name. Or I want to have every data that you have on me. Yes, you have the right. That's why, as big as Facebook is, they fall into trouble. They are trouble. And as a matter of fact, with those data alone, that is how the likes of Trump was able to win the election. The likes of, what is it called? Obama was able to win an election. It wasn't by their shared geniuses. And of course, it's also part of it because they were able to use data. They took American citizen data, took it to a company, Cambridge Analytics, in the United Kingdom, not in America, took it there for that company to use that data. So imagine, let me see for example. What the possible is to redesign the system. That's the possible solution to it. And those people who are the regulators, they need to be taught. They don't know what they are doing. They need to be taught. They need to be schooled. They need to be schooled on what they need to do. So that is critically important. That is critically important. Very, very important. So let's say, for example, now, one politician got in touch with me. I can make PDP to win Nigeria election without rigging. I can make anybody win election. Let me just print this now. Let me round up with this. If a politician contact me now, I'm not saying go and give my details to them because you are breaching law if you give my details. If you do, I will not even listen to them. I don't have time for Nigeria now. The only time I have time for Nigeria is to help them to change things, not to make one policy, because I have not seen anyone that is ready to win that election, that is ready to even do the right thing. What they need to do is, imagine now, Facebook has 33% of the world data, not Nigeria, 33%. So Facebook is a gap. All I just need to do is to have your data. And very easy. Once I have your data, I can, from here, send messages to you. I'll be telling you what this guy is going to do. And be telling you his background, what he believes in. But one among them is doing that. They will just go to one national stadium that at the end of the campaign, they will kill themselves. So without necessarily going to national stadium, you can do something from the comfort of your bedroom and your toilet with your mobile phone. There's a lot you can do, but they don't know. So they need to be schooled. I don't want to talk too much about how to make a, because that's not a, I'm not looking for that at all. I'm not really not looking for that. I don't want to be looking at my back and be watching my back. You know, Nigeria is very funny. It's very, very funny. So there are ways to do these things. There are ways to do these things. Imagine if First Bank approached me now. I can make all the citizens in Nigeria to leave GTB Bank and come to First Bank. I can do that. All you just need to do. Now, Lasso is good. Yes, Lasso is beautiful. Lasso is one of the best schools, isn't it? But imagine as good as Lasso is. You don't have platform to start showing how good Lasso is. Tell me, how would they know that Lasso is good? The only people that will know Lasso is good, The only people that will know Lasso is good is people that eventually come to Lasso and see how good Lasso is. Simple. But we can make the whole world to know by sending the developmental issues, great things that happen in Lasso to people. That's what you're supposed to do. Yeah, they manipulated the elections. Yes, they did. They did by using data. Guess what? If you go to Netflix, there's a movie there called The Ad. One guy, one American citizen had to employ a lawyer in UK to sue Cambridge Analytics, because Cambridge Analytics is in UK, to withdraw his own data. No, don't even go there. Are they serious about data security? They are not. They are not serious about anything. Now, that's why when you go to any shopping mall and you use your card to make any payment, don't play with the receipt. Ensure you collect your receipt, that paper receipt, and make sure you tear it in pieces such that it cannot be put together again. Very critical. Otherwise, that's why some of you lose money. You might not even know Yahoo Yahoo is collecting money. Imagine if you have 1,000 in your account and 1 naira left your, or 10 naira left your, let's say 10 naira left your account. You will feel it. Or have you not noticed that sometimes when you go back to your bank balance, it has just reduced by 10 naira, but you won't feel it. You won't call your attention to it. You won't call the bank attention to it. You won't feel it. Imagine now, 10 naira for 1 million people. You know how much that is. So a lot of people are losing money. They don't know. So when you play with your, when you buy stuff online and you are playing with the receipt, or you left it anyhow and somebody gets in there, they don't have to take the whole of the 1,000 naira. They don't have to take 500. They will take an amount that you will not even think about, that something is happening in your account. So imagine if they take that from millions of people. How would you? You can imagine the amount of money. You can imagine. Suddenly you will see that the system has tell you that £50 have left your account. Very silly. A lot of things needs to be put right. So I'm sure if there are questions in the auditorium, can we quickly address it in 5 minutes? If you have questions online, if you're online, please quickly ask your questions while I answer those questions before I give the button to the next teacher who is going to teach digital project management, please. Yes, thank you. I like what you just said, that they had to lie. They had to lie that there was no server, or it was not act. If you imagine if the whole of Nigeria sue INEC or sue Nigeria federal government, they would just drain the pulse, because that is a breach, a big one, a very big one. So when they are collecting your data, they are doing sensors, whatever they are doing, They are supposed to put it there that your data is protected, and they will not use it beyond what has been stated. It won't go beyond what has been stated. And they will ensure that they have the right security mechanism in place to protect your data. Very key. Okay, you know, it's not about knowing, it's about who you are. Because they are also wise. They are very, very wise. So it's who you give your data. The only way to protect your data from giving your data out. So know who you give. Don't read everything that you think on. Some of us are very in it. So much in it to give our data. And that site has asked you to want to access. Because you want to watch that movie, or you want to read that article, you could click yes. Without being through the safeguards, what they put there. So you just be careful who you give your data to. And periodically change your password, change your stuff. Change your password, whether you are using Yahoo, because you are not the owner of Yahoo, and you did not pay to have Yahoo domain, or Gmail, or Outlook, or whatever email that you have. You didn't pay for it. So they have the access to do anything with your data. So because you did not pay for it and you are not, it's free. So you have got to be careful and read the safeguards. I mean, the document sent to you, whether hard copy, whether digital copy, ensure you read it properly before you give your consent. You remember, consent is still in your hand. You still have the consent. You still have the wherewithal to give the go-ahead on how people should have access to your data. So that's critically key.
That's key. So admin in Nigeria, do we have access, because we only have the 2 minutes to have the next class. Do you have any question from the all, please? But whatever question that we have, we need to do it within 2 minutes. Yeah, that's why that's why the cashless thing that they said they proposed they are going to do, they've not been able to do it. Because the thing is, it's a whole lot of, it's expensive to do, but at the same time, it's better than the paperwork. It's more expensive to, it's more cheaper to go digital and put the right system in place than to be using paper. Because once there's a breach, you will lose what you are trying to protect. So that's why quite a number of government agencies in Nigeria, Central Bank, NNPC inclusive, all those big guys, they are not transiting to the right system. They are still using the traditional method because they are scared of quite a lot of things and they have not been able to put a lot of things in place. I won't say they are scared. I won't say they. It's just because of negligence and that nonchalant attitude. And there's no agency monitoring them. That's why I said that the effectiveness of different agencies that regulate data usage in different countries differs. It's totally different. The one in Nigeria, you can't compare with the one in Europe. So that's key. So if we don't have any question from... You just report to the... make sure you have evidence. And like I said, they are supposed to even report themselves within 72 hours. The body, any organization, they are supposed to report themselves. But if that happens, just ensure that you have evidence. So if somebody calls you now and is disturbing, just tell the person to send you an email and then report the person to the regulatory body or report the company to the regulatory body in your country. That's what you're supposed to do. That's how to get your redress. Why is the government not going to private companies like that? That's a long question, and that's a tall order. And I think at this point, this is where I draw the curtain. Thank you very much. I know you guys have had fun. Like we said, please ensure that you go to YouTube, TC Resource Technology channel, and subscribe. That's where you can get the video. And we will only give our slide to people who have subscribed. So by the end of today, I'm sure we have quite hundreds of you in the all. We need you to subscribe to the very critical and very important. And then you'll be able to have access to some of these slides that we are showing to you. I think I would stop the recording and call the digital project management teacher, Tyler Richard. Good morning.